never been here for a team to sing their fight song on our field. Quite frankly, it's just embarrassing. It's embarrassing. We let down our fans, our coaches, and everybody that, you know, supports our program for to allow them to sing OHIO on our field.
You think they heard it in Norman? Man, are they going to hear it tonight on the Buckeyes' home field. That taunt seared in the Sooner memory. But tonight, a chance for redemption. A September showdown with stakes that will carry all season long. And tonight at the Shoe, could the Shoe be on the other foot? The Sooners ride in on the nation's longest winning streak. The last time Oklahoma lost, the last time they saw the Buckeyes. This is the headliner for a season-shaping Saturday. So as they say around here, hang on, Sloopy, hang on. College game day from the banks of the Olentangy. 5-1 at home all time against non-conference top five opponents. Do they get that win tonight against OU?
I tell you what, we saw Ohio State's defense struggle in the first half against Indiana. They made some adjustments. I think they're going to play an exceptional game tonight against Baker Mayfield. I'm going Buckeyes because of their defense.
Yeah, yeah. Listen, I'm at home. So I truly believe Ohio State will win tonight because of their defensive line. Baker Mayfield, I think, will play better than he did last year. Mm-hmm. But I think it's going to be too much Ohio State. The offense is getting going. I really like J.K. Dobbins, the freshman running back. He is going to be special here at Ohio State. So I like the Buckeyes to win tonight in a close one.
Okay, sweetheart. Tell your friends here what I do when I pick Oklahoma.
When you pick Oklahoma, you put the little white hat on, and then you shoot the guns.
Uh-oh.
That's what you do.
You ever see it? Oh, man. Look at it. You think people would like to see that again?
About three of them.
Yeah, yeah. Shoot the gun, coach. I want to see it.
Three or four might.
I'd like to see it.
You think you'd like to see Brutus again?
Oh, they love to see Brutus.
They see Brutus way too much.
Give me Brutus. Here, this is your school. You pick them.
Hey, this is your thing. I'm not putting this on. There we go.
He gave David on that flag, too. He's calling the game tonight. Maria Taylor, my man's pilot. Right now, we are ready in Louisville, North Carolina. Dave Pass, Greg McElroy, and Tom Lugenbell. Eddie, thanks so much.
Todd Holley, thank you so much. He's a two-time walk-on, a two-time Heisman finalist. Baker Mayfield looking for revenge tonight from a year ago. His challenge, to beat the Buckeyes at the Horseshoe. Number 2, Ohio State. Number 5, Oklahoma. Ahead at 7:30 on ABC. Turning 34 on Tuesday, youngest active coach in FBS. He talked to our Maria Taylor before tonight's game.
Coach, we know that Baker Mayfield is a huge catalyst for this team. What do you need to see him from him early in this top five matchup to know you guys are on the right track?
Just continue to do what he's doing. He's played very well last week, you know, trusted the guys around him, was very settled in early. He's been in atmospheres like this, and that needs to show tonight.
All right, this is your first time being in an atmosphere like this. How did it feel coming out of that tunnel? You're the youngest coach in FBS, and you're coaching in a top five matchup on the road.
Yeah, I feel good. You know, I don't think about myself. I think about the staff and players I have around me, and that gives me all the confidence I need.
All right, thanks for your time, Coach.
Thank you.
The following is a special presentation of ESPN on ABC.
Sunset in central Ohio on a beautiful day as we welcome you to Saturday Night Football presented by Wells Fargo and this presentation of the Big Ten on ABC. The old horseshoe at the banks of the Olentangy, a sea of scarlet for this anticipated collision between two top five teams, number 5 Oklahoma and number 2 Ohio State. And welcome to Columbus, Chris Fowler and Kirk Herbstreit. How cool to have these two heavyweight programs colliding here, just the fourth time ever, and it's Oklahoma's first visit here in 40 years. If we get half as good a game as that 77 Classic, it'll be fun tonight.
That was one of my first memories as a college football fan. Last second field goal, some big names on the sideline and also on the field. Hopefully we get a game like that.
Woody Hayes versus Barry Switz. We'll talk more about that game coming up. Meanwhile, Oklahoma is driven by this loss at home to Ohio State last year. Biggest crowd in Norman history. The Buckeyes made some great plays, put 35 on the board at halftime, won it going away, and then sang the alma mater right in front of Oklahoma's team.
Yeah, and they're just not used to seeing that. No. Baker Mayfield came out this week and said that, you know, that image has really been around this week, and they're not going to hide from the fact that they're motivated by that. I think Oklahoma comes in because of their leader, Baker Mayfield, with a big chip on their shoulder. That's kind of his game. That's how he plays. He likes to go on the road. He likes the us against the world mentality, and he's going to show it the way he plays, the way he throws, and the way he runs. Now, big thing he's got to do, he's got to get the ball out of his hands quickly tonight. Make quick decisions and be in rhythm early with his wide receivers. This is the aspect of his game that's huge against this Ohio State defensive line. Ability to improvise and create. Keep plays alive. Something to keep in mind tonight. When he scrambles, he's looking to scramble to throw. Not necessarily scrambling to run to take off. He's looking to buy time to make a big throw. And Mark Andrews, his big tight end, is a guy he's going to be dialing up, number 81.
Mayfield, 19-20 against UTEP. Did whatever they wanted. Their offensive line, they think, is one of the best in the country. We can't wait to watch the matchup against these guys. Buckeyes think they got the best D-line in the country.
Yeah, you talk about the game within the game, that big, experienced Oklahoma offensive line trying to take care of Baker Mayfield against Tyquan Lewis and Sam Hubbard and company. It's a very deep, very athletic, very physical front, and they feel confident in their ability to chase down, give different looks to Baker Mayfield, to try to spy him, which was successful a year ago in Norman. But make no mistake, how that offensive line takes care of him, how they do in the run game. No more Samaje Perine, no more Joe Mixon, breaking in a whole new crew in that backfield. If Oklahoma's going to come in here and win, it can't just be Baker Mayfield alone. He needs somebody to help him out running the football with that offensive line, trying to get a dent against that D-line.
And how about the coaching matchup? You got Urban Meyer, those three national titles, one of the best in the world in his profession. And Lincoln Riley for Oklahoma taking over for Bob Stoops. He turned 34 on Tuesday. First test as a head coach. Oklahoma and Ohio State coming up from Columbus.
The Nissan pregame rush with Kevin Negandhi, Mac Brown, and Booger McFarland is next after this message.
It's always wins Ohio State.
So they got guys like you.
Yeah, a lot of them.
they do have a lot. They roll them in. I'm going Ohio State at the Shoe. Have to. Been there, done that.
That environment's loud,
it's
right?
It's really hard to win. You can't even hear yourself think when you don't even want to.
Lincoln Riley's second game as a head coach at Oklahoma. We'll see you at the half. Let's go to Chris Fowler.
A unique tradition, part of the pageantry of Ohio State football, the dotting of the I by a senior sousaphone player. The honor tonight is Tim Hogue from Canton McKinley, a graduate in May in security and intelligence with a minor in Russian. This might not be the most important thing he does in his life, but it is fulfilling a dream he's had since he was in high school. Doesn't get a lot better than Script, Ohio. Kirk will tell you the band ranks way up there, perhaps above the team many seasons.
For a lot of people. It's a big deal.
Between these two programs, they have 13 national championships, according to the major wire services. You can see the success in their respective conferences. A dozen Heisman Trophy winners between them. And they have, of course, been pipelines of first-round talent to the NFL. Just 14 wins difference. Ohio State the edge all time. And what a rare treat as they complete this home-and-home series in Columbus here tonight. Oklahoma prides itself on being one of the best road teams in the country. They have not lost a game since that home defeat to Ohio State a year ago. They have the nation's longest win streak at 11. It takes a special team to deal with this environment on the road, and Baker Mayfield thinks the Sooners have that. But guys, don't lose on home turf often. Urban Meyer's had the look in his eye, but the big game hasn't he the last 24 hours. Mayfield and the Sooner captains about to walk into this sea of noise. And the Buckeyes enter through a laser show. Seven-point underdogs feeling a little bit forgotten as the road team here. We'll see if the Sooners can translate that into a big performance. Coach is getting ready. Not another game.
He may cover the opening kickoff.
Lasers, pyrotechnics, smoke, they don't miss a trick. Things have changed since the Woody Hayes era. Imagine being a 34-year-old just a few days and being in charge of a program with this challenge. It's going to be interesting to see Lincoln Riley, a play-calling prodigy, Kirk, as he transforms to the head man now. The Sooners and the Buckeyes. Doesn't have a great sound to it, does it? Kickoff coming up.
Nobody pray for me. It's been a day for me. Yeah.
Oklahoma, Ohio State, there's a lot of history in both programs.
It's a huge matchup. Both of these teams have aspirations to play for a national title.
He's the quarterback you don't want to face.
We do.
This has been the Nissan pregame rush. Kickoff from Columbus is next. And now we'll look.
I see how this is gonna go. Touch me and you'll never be alone. Island breeze and lights down low. No one has to know. In the middle of the night.
Early September in Oklahoma visiting Ohio State. It's a treat in college football. You get the big neutral site games, Kirk. Not often do teams take on the challenge of a home and home. It's been kind of a dying tradition. We're happy that these two programs revived it.
Yeah, it's great to see these games in September. And as you say, sometimes you see a neutral site game, but it's great to see Joe Castiglione from Oklahoma, the athletic director, and Gene Smith from Ohio State come together and get this home and home set up.
Buckeyes won the toss and deferred, so Lincoln Riley's offense will get the football first as we say hello to Maria Taylor on the sidelines on this very pleasant evening. Hi, Maria.
Well, hello, Chris. And you've mentioned Baker Mayfield already and his motivation in this game, but he is taking it very personally despite passing for nearly 300 yards in last year's game. What sticks out is those two interceptions and that he feels as though he put his team in a situation where they couldn't battle back from. He has 14 phrases up in his locker room, and one of them is be the best college football player in the nation. And I will say this D-line is looking forward to getting after him. They say he's the best competitor they've ever played against in Ohio State. Well, they want to bottle him up early, guys.
Baker, tell me nobody in the sport has more fun playing the game than him. But Kirk,
That's what he did a year ago. He had such hype following the 15 season, finishing up near the top of the Heisman, that I think he came into 16 against Houston and especially Ohio State with some new players around him, and he tried to do too much. He's got to try to let the game come to him tonight.
A true freshman will get it started here. Blake Pauwbill to kick it away for Ohio State. Jeff Badette, one of the talented receivers, a transfer from Kentucky, number two, is back with Michael Jones. It's a short kick and returnable for Badette. Right up the middle, a little crease, and he's knocked down at the 28-yard line. The kicker got in there on the tackle, and here comes Baker Mayfield.
We just talked about how important it is for him to let the game come to him. 6'1", 220 pounds, one of the best players, not quarterbacks, players in college football. Poise on the road. He's got some young players around him. He's got to be able to keep his cool, especially early. Getting the ball out quickly against that pass rush from Ohio State. And then the ball placement, something we saw Richard Lego from Indiana have success on the back shoulder fade against young defensive backs. He can't just throw the ball. He's got to put it where his receiver has a chance to make a play on it away from a defender.
Abdul Adams is the back behind Mayfield. And then you see Dimitri Flowers, the fullback. Mayfield has a lot of freedom to do this. Change plays pre-snap. Fake and a throw over the middle. And Flowers out of the backfield makes the catch. Kind of retreated, and he'll be tackled a yard short of a first down by Damon Webb.
Love the call. You've got Lincoln Riley. He knows he's on the road. Defense is excited in front of their home crowd. They get an aggressive defense out of position. A little delay. Kind of a pop pass back to the tight end, his favorite target.
Flowers, a very experienced player. 40th career game. Now Adams has a little crease and a quick spurt out to the 45 for a first down. Chris Worley made the tackle. Here's our Chick-fil-A impact players, Kirk.
They're going tempo here. We'll try to squeeze this in real quick. When Oklahoma has the football, not only is it Baker Mayfield, but he's got a lot of players around him. Orlando Brown, the left tackle. Mark Andrews, 81. For Ohio State, Tremont Jones in the inside. And Denzel Ward, number 12, has got to be a leader out isolated one-on-one in coverage tonight.
Made a big pick in the opener against Indiana to seal things. Another quick throw, and it's batted down at the line of scrimmage. Tyquan Lewis, the senior who decided to come back for one more year in Columbus, made the play.
You talked about getting the ball out quickly. Ohio State has that scouting report as well. And Tyquan Lewis, he knows he can't get in there, but the presence of mind to be able to time that up and knock that football down. Remember, that was an issue last year for Baker Mayfield against Ohio State. Jerome Baker ended up having a pick six. It was off a tip ball. Remember, he's listed at 6'1", but he's fairly short against that big D-line.
Second down, Adams darts ahead. It'll be interesting to see how Greg Schiano calls the defensive pressure for trying to rattle a guy who's tough to rattle.
But it's very tough to rattle a guy who's played as many games. It's his 35th start. He's seen about every defense you can imagine. But you can try to affect the others around him with disguising coverages, disguising blitzes. Here's the first third down look. This is where Ohio State tries to really confuse the line and get after the quarterback.
Empty backfield. Adams, the tailback, is the far right of the formation. Buckeyes get him out of the pocket, but an accurate throw and a first down catch by C.D. Lamb, the talented true freshman.
Ohio State playing man-to-man and using Baker in the middle of the field as kind of a spy. When you play man-to-man, you're counting on your receivers to get separation. And the young true freshman, Lamb, does exactly that to get Baker Mayfield a chance at the first down.
He's out of Texas. They expect a big career. Now a direct snap, little trickery as Adams takes it, and he rumbles forward down near first down yardage inside the 35.
That Oklahoma offensive line, we heard about that battle. How are they going to do up front? Take a look and watch how they're doing. Cody Ford, 74. Nice job on a double team. They get a good push down block by Orlando Brown. And listen, Oklahoma recruits running backs. I know they don't have Samaje Perine or Joe Mixon, but they've got talent in that backfield that you'll see tonight.
So far, it's been all Abdul Adams. We expect a rotation of three Sooner backs. A frenetic start as the Sooners are using a lot of tempo. But Adams that time trapped in the backfield for a loss. Greasy Sprinkle, a big anchor in the middle of the senior, made the tackle.
It was a little bit of movement by Sprinkle. Talked about, what is Greg Schiano going to do? How's he going to come after them? Instead of coming here, he actually shoots around. I think creates a little bit of confusion up front, and that's what allowed him to shoot that gap fairly untouched and surprise the Oklahoma back, Abdul Adams.
So a third and four, they're in fringe field goal range.
And the man across.
Mayfield looks to the right and delivers a high throw, incomplete. Going up for it was Jeff Badette. The throw too high, and it's fourth down.
Interesting call, and he has the option to go to the inside routes or to go to the outside. It's a tough, long throw against Ohio State's best cover man.
Mayfield lobbying Kirk to go for it in fourth down, and I think he's won that one. They're going to go here. Need four.
Kind of in that in-between area where you're maybe too long for the field goal, and you don't want to punt it, so let's take a shot. When you have an experienced quarterback, you can do that.
Up your backfield again. Mayfield makes a downfield throw, incomplete. Tried to loop it to Lamb, but he was well covered by Kendall Sheffield, and the Buckeye defense holds.
This Ohio State secondary took some shots from some folks about people questioning how good they might be after Indiana threw the football with a lot of success in their first half. And most of those plays, they were in phase and good coverage. Indiana just made some plays. Tonight, they're off to a better start.
Adams, a first down carry, loses the ball. Buckeyes say they have it. Chris Worley knocked it loose in the Knights' first turnover. Jayshon Cornell came up with the football. And Ohio State once again makes a stand in its own territory.
It is Chris Worley who's moved to that middle linebacker spot. Perfect form, shoulder pad right on the football, knocks that ball loose, and then Cornell, presence of mind there to pop, jump on top of the football to recover the turnover for Ohio State.
So twice Oklahoma has moved.
Wells Fargo in this presentation of the Big Ten on ABC. The Sooners involved in a scoreless first quarter for the first time in 4 years. Not that unusual for Ohio State.
No, and Ohio State, you know, they got off to a slow start against Indiana. Slow start tonight. Oklahoma, we talked a lot in this broadcast, 119 yards to Ohio State's 25. They've been much more aggressive.
All three possessions, they've reached Ohio State territory now. Mayfield gets it out very quick. The ball bobbled by Badette. That was very close to a backwards pass. Damon Webb comes up with the football.
That's exactly right,
incomplete.
Chris. Yeah, that's exactly right. Is it a backwards pass? We know he didn't catch it.
The receiver never had possession of the football.
Yeah, I don't think it's an issue about having possession. I think it's a lateral. Chris, you're all over it there at the beginning.
Yeah, he never came up with it, but if it's a lateral, that's a fumble. And Webb did make a pretty quick recovery. Let's bring in Dave Kataya.
You guys are absolutely right. To me, in this angle, that's a backward pass, and I don't care about possession. The ball is loose. Here we have an immediate
ball handler and faker, isn't he? Barrett fakes it again, but that time a play made in the backfield by Okoronkwo, his second big play tonight.
That's what speed can do for you. Okoronkwo at 6'1", 240. The right guard, Brandon Bowen, trying to get out there, 76. Watch how he tries to get out there, but see that quickness, that suddenness? The vision for Okoronkwo, that's what allows him to make that play out on the edge of the defense.
One of the captains on this Oklahoma team. So second and goal. Back from the 12-yard line. Barrett from the pocket. Has time. Still looking. Fires across the middle, incomplete. It's a low throw. He comes across his body trying to get it to Austin Mack. Third and goal.
Got to give Oklahoma credit for the coverage. JT Barrett doing his best to keep that play alive, but the secondary had good coverage downfield, and Gallimore, 90 for a big guy, chasing down JT Barrett. He's 310 pounds trying to chase JT Barrett. I mean, they've got size down in this area with Benjamin Victor.
Weber is back in the game. You see, okay, and they motion him out. Sooners rush five. Complete over the middle. Hard hit. Campbell knocked down at the five immediately by Will Johnson, and it's fourth down.
Will Johnson on the stop.
Offense still on the field for the moment, and now Meyer says he'll take the three.
Gain to the 6 yard line, fourth and goal on Ohio State.
Buckeyes reach the red zone, but the Sooners make a stand there. Sean Nurnberger, field goal kicker 3 years ago, who was beaten out each of the last 2 years by a graduate transfer, comes back to reclaim the job. 18 for 26 in his career. This one just 24. And so Ohio State moves it from midfield and settles for three after the Sooners' second turnover. 3-0.
Tell him it's a, we don't want to speculate, but it looks like he's favoring something on that right side.
Buckeye shows some pressure immediately, flipped over the middle, and it is Dimitri Flowers. The big H-back makes another catch and rumbles down to the 25 before Worley stopped him.
What a call by Lincoln Riley, man-to-man right here, and he's lined up with him because of the blitz and the delay. Watch 36 kind of get lost, and then he slips out. Just a little bit of a slight delay, almost like a slip screen, but I think Chris Worley got caught with his eyes in the backfield wondering if Baker Mayfield might be taking off, and he lost his eyes on his man, and it freed him up.
Even hobbled a bit. Mayfield picking up yardage in chunks. They got 20 that time. Retreating, rolling, and he's got enough in those wheels to scamper for a nice gain. See where they spot him. I thought he was getting closer to the 20. They're going to put the ball to 23.
You know, last year, he and Lincoln Riley talked about how he was pressing. He was trying to make too many things happen. He looks like a different guy going through this again, dealing with the pressure, finishing third in the Heisman. He's just a grizzled veteran. And right now, with a lot of new personnel around him at wide receiver and running back, his poise, which is a big aspect of tonight, is being put on display.
Ball spotted at the 22 now. Mayfield across the middle, threw it behind Calcaterra, the freshman tight end filling in for Andrews.
Yeah, they got Ohio State right now on their heels. They're pushing the right buttons. The play is there. And I know we've talked about Andrews being out. Calcaterra, you don't want to give up on him. This ball's thrown behind, but that's a catch. The only thing he did is he peeked down to see where that,
didn't he?
Yeah, he's starting to see if he's going to get hit. But if he holds on to that ball, it's at least a first down and probably a touchdown.
So you see the impact of the veteran not being in there right away. Mayfield needs six on third down. Buckeyes bring pressure, and Sermon tries to squirt free. He's tackled a few yards short by Nick Bosa. And Riley again, this time is going to send out the field goal team.
Yeah, I mean, we've seen him go for it twice. It was a lot further out. He's much closer to give his kicker a much better chance of trying to tie this game up.
And his kicker is a veteran. Austin Seibert does the punting and kicking. Did not attempt a field goal in the blowout over UTEP. For his career, he's 29 of 39. This from 37 to tie the ball game. And the timing was messed up. The snap not cleanly handled by Connor McGinnis, the holder. And the kick is wide right. And another nice drive by Oklahoma results in no points.
That's as much on the snap as it is the hold. And the snap is low. Hunter does the holder does the best job that he can of trying to get that ball down.
But again, Oklahoma gained a bunch of yards, but no points.
By Pacific Life, experience the power of Pacific and Chevy. The only brand to earn J.D. Power Dependability Awards for cars, trucks, and SUVs 2 years in a row.
Buckeyes take over up three midway second quarter. See the retired numbers. I see a four up there, but that's just that's got to be rectified very soon.
Oh, yeah.
Here.
Oh, absolutely. Some big names up there.
Oklahoma's moved the ball every time. A turnover, a fourth down stop, and now a missed field goal, and they have come up empty. So Barrett, another first down carry. This is a treat. Bob Stoops, after 18 years as the boss of Oklahoma, back in your home state, what has to be an absolutely surreal experience to look at a game that you're not involved in coaching from up here.
No, I've said it a few times today. It's like I'm in the Twilight Zone, you know, so it is very surreal, but all good. Proud of the team. They're playing hard, playing well. Lincoln's doing a great job.
It reminded me a little bit of you in your younger days. Fourth down plus territory. I mean, both times they're pressing. They're going for it. They're on the road. Tough environment. They're here to win.
Absolutely. And I agree with them. 35-yard line. Yeah. You have to do that. Lincoln's doing a great job. Calling a great game. We've been close to popping a few big plays and have, but got to take care of the ball and finish.
In terms of road openers as a head coach, a guy that just turned 34, this is a pretty interesting challenge for a guy that you feel has the goods to be a great head coach. Sooners trying to get off the field here on defense, but Barrett's going to scramble for another first down, still running out across the 40.
Now Lincoln's he's wise beyond his years. You know, even though he's only 34, he's had great experience that's put him in great position to handle this.
You ever feel like texting something down or like somehow getting a message? You've been doing this for so long. This is your boy. This is your boy.
I did place a call earlier. My wife, my daughter and wife were laughing at me, so no one answered on the other end.
Dobbins makes the catch, but the Sooner defense up to stop him. Oklahoma has had such a great history of being a road team. Talking to Baker Mayfield about that this week. Your teams are known for being able to come into an environment like this and deal with it. What do you see in this group that makes you feel they're ready for this challenge tonight?
Well, they're playing really well. You know, we've just a couple of turnovers, you know, taking care of the football. But these guys have been in big games, all these guys. You know, we're Oklahoma. We're used to that. Every year we have big non-conference games. This is just another one.
Boy, Mike's defense so far, I mean, we've still got another 2.5 quarters to go, but really impressive with the way they played tonight, playing with a little bit of an edge and attitude.
We're playing sharp, smart. You could tell, you know, they're going to make some plays, but they're doing a really good job.
Ohio State needs 9 on this play. And Barrett has time in the pocket, but now it collapses, and he's thrown down by Okoronkwo, who again imposes himself against that Ohio State offensive line.
We talked about that matchup with Okoronkwo because of how athletic he is against Isaiah Prince. Right out here, surprised that Ohio State leaves him one-on-one on third down. Spin move, doesn't give up on it. JT Barrett waiting for separation, and it's Isaiah Prince at that right tackle spot.
You know this guy, Bob?
Mike's playing with him.
That's the body English.
I got to admit, I was doing the same thing in the box next to him. So when I'm on the field, I don't need to do it as much, but in the box, you do. It seems like you're helping him.
They force a punt, and it's the dad mishandles it, but falls on it. Bob, I wish you a tremendous retirement in the Twilight Zone. Thanks for your time. All former coaches end up here at some point, so we'll see you.
Well, maybe. Thank you, Chris.
Thanks,
all right, man. Sooners go back on offense, down by 3, especially not from the home team.
87 yards, Chris, at this point for Ohio State's offense.
There was a kick catch interference on that fair catch, so a 15-yard penalty, and Ohio State moves it to the 28 to start this Sooner possession. Mayfield flips it short, and the catch is made by Sermon out of the backfield for a 9-yard gain.
Well, what they're doing back there, because they have a veteran quarterback, a guy they trust, they're just giving Ohio State's linebackers and safeties a lot of different looks, whether it's the motions or it's a cross action where you fake up the middle that time to Anderson, then you get the young freshman out in the flat. You can see Ohio State just kind of waiting, hesitant, and not real sure where the ball is.
It was a two-back look, and this is Rodney Anderson motioning out, makes the catch, makes a nice cut, and is out near midfield for a first down. Chris Brule made the tackle. They're using the backs as receivers a bunch.
Well, they have to. And the other thing that they've done is there's Baker Mayfield hobbling off again. Now this is where Kyler Murray's got to come in and play some real football tonight.
Injuries beginning to mount to Oklahoma, and you couldn't pick worse players to be hampered with Andrews apparently out. Mayfield has hobbled. And now the talented runner, the sophomore, Murray comes in. And the first down pitch, they get it back, And Murray, he showed you the acceleration and the speed. He brings an element.
It's a different gear when he gets the ball. How about the play call, by the way? Backup quarterback comes in. First play, he gets a chance to be able to run. How about a handoff, pitch back to the backup quarterback, and let him get to the corner? I just talked about how they're giving a lot of different looks. This is a different look and a different gear from Murray, who gets to the corner and picks up 9 in a hurry.
You see number 4 pitching. It's like shades of Jamel Holloway back in the day.
I mean,
that's
glory days.
Different kind of option look. Mayfield's back. He's been in and out a couple times now. Second and 1 play. Mayfield's going to keep it. He's healthy enough to run the football, and they move the sticks to the 40.
You know, it's funny when he comes back from being taken off the field, and he looks like there's nothing wrong.
And they run it, a design run.
Right.
Andrews with the ice on the knee. Oklahoma, Kirk, for the 5th time in 5 drives. They've crossed midfield. They've threatened consistently. He's not been able to convert. Sermon slips free and shows some power. He's not really considered one of the main backs in the rotation, but he is tonight.
No, I think they're still trying to find their way with the loss of Joe Mixon and Samaje Perine. They've got a committee there. We've seen mostly Abdul Adams. We've seen a little bit of Rodney Anderson and Trey Sermon, a true freshman. Powerful back for a freshman at 225 pounds. Playing with a little bit of emotion tonight, too, for a young guy. He's probably been thinking about this opportunity and this kind of stage his whole life.
He got 9 on second down. He's got it again. Boom, slams forward for a first down at the 25. About 2.5 to go before halftime.
And these college coaches that are coaching at the elite level, when they bring in true freshmen, they're looking to play them. It's not about redshirting. They're looking to play them. And so what you have to do if you come in for spring, you try to get him acclimated, which Sermon had a chance to be in for spring, and you get him in against that first-team defense, and you try to give him a feel of what fast defense is all about, so when they get into a game like this, they're ready to play at game speed.
They feel a first-down shot for the end zone. Loop down there. Battle for the ball incomplete. Jeffrey Meade was very well defended. Denzel Ward on coverage.
As soon as he threw the ball, Jerome Baker, 17, is going to lower the boom right there.
Wow.
Man, ball is pretty good coverage by Denzel Ward trying to use the sideline.
Baker, the guy that had the big pick 6 against Mayfield last year, delivering a hard shot. Rodney Anderson. He is now the bat. He gets a turn. Anderson bursts free. Well, you see those other guys running well. If you get an opportunity like Anderson did, you want to make something of it. He got about 8.
He absolutely did. And we've talked about this battle up front. How is it going to go? Watch the right tackle, Bobby Evans, gets Draymond Jones, puts him on his back. That is it. You want to watch old school football? Watch this Oklahoma veteran offensive line against the talented Buckeye defensive line. There are some wars going on up front.
You see Bosa get knocked sideways?
Yeah.
Cody Ford is a backup, came around.
Absolutely. 74.
Focus on the trenches in this 3rd and 2. Play clock at 1, and now they'll have to spend a timeout to talk about this crucial play. Minute 20 to go before halftime. Riley's offense has moved it all over the place, come up empty so far. See if that changes before halftime. They were the better team in this first half. Don't have the lead to show for it yet. A lot of talk about this 3rd down play. Let's see what they came up with. Mayfield from the pocket. A lot of time. Now backpedals. Escapes. And is going to be knocked down just short of the marker. Jalen Holmes chased him down, and now a decision as the clock runs 1:05 before halftime.
You know, Ohio State, they didn't even try to get upfield. They just tried to squeeze him in the pocket and not allow him to get out. And then, as you say, another big decision.
This time they're going to take the 3. Yep. Yeah, they need about 1.5 yards. And I think the feeling, Kirk, you've done all this work. You outgained Ohio State by more than 2-1. If you don't have any points,
they don't have a point.
Yeah. I think that's behind this decision. Seibert, who was wide right after the blow snap the first time. Got to hurry if they're going to get it off. They just do. And this time he knocks it right through. So it takes until the final 25 seconds of the first half for Oklahoma to get on the board and tie the game at three as we check in with Cassidy Hubbard.
Thanks, Chris.
Now, I think they invaded in huge numbers. Way more people went up than had tickets, right?
Oh, yeah. I mean, they would love to fill the entire stadium if they could.
Notre Dame fans wouldn't quite let that happen.
No, I remember one year you and I, and game day, we went up to a Nebraska Notre Dame game, and a sea of red came into South Bend that day.
We saw Mayfield, who was 11 of 18 in the first half. There's Barrett, who's had a frustrating day throwing the ball this week. But Baker has been hobbled. He's been banged up. He took that shot from Jerome Baker. He's knocked off his feet. That's a bigger concern than the leg, I think, at this point.
I'll tell you what, it's going to take a lot for Six to come out of the game. He is as competitive as a guy as there is in the country.
But he's a guy that has fun. There's a lot of joy in his game. I don't think he's having a lot of fun now because he's just trying to manage himself physically. Hill and Campbell back deep to receive the kick. And this is Campbell who will leave it right there. 1977, Oklahoma's come from behind victory right here 40 years ago.
First meeting in history between these two great football teams with 6 seconds to play. 41-yard field goal to win it. It is good. Wow. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't believe you can watch a more exciting football game anywhere.
Uwe Detlef Walker von Schaman from 41 yards to win it. That was a heck of a comeback. They had the score touchdown, went for two, didn't get it, got the onside kick to get the ball back to get in position, and that was a thriller. That was the last visit by Oklahoma here. We can hope for some fireworks in the second half to equal that one. It's 24 seconds, and this is Dobbins. He's dangerous anytime he touches it. Hey, listen, man, we both grew up listening to our games like that.
Absolutely.
So that'll be it. Ohio State's offense doesn't do a whole lot. 91 yards in the BMW halftime report to Kevin Negandhi, Mac Brown, and Booger McFarland is coming up. Scores and highlights from a busy day. An analysis from this one as Mayfield slowly makes his way. Oklahoma, 222 yards, ran off a dozen more plays, got in Ohio State territory 5 times, but for a variety of reasons, it is just 3-3. Down to Maria.
All right, Coach, under 100 yards of total offense. How would you assess that side of the ball?
That's terrible. We got to play much better, and our defense is hanging in there. A couple turnovers, but that's terrible.
Well, how do you change that around in the second half?
Go meet on it right now.
Okay. Right. Thanks, Coach.
Not mincing words. Terrible, in a word. Meyer on his offensive performance in the first half. But it is 3-3 into the first half in Columbus. The BMW halftime report right after these messages. Saturday Night Football, presented by Wells Fargo, and this presentation of the Big Ten on ABC. Sooners of the Buckeyes deadlocked at 3. An interesting first half. Last year's meeting, 52 points scored in the first half, 35 by Ohio State. It was kind of a first half knockout in Norman. This is very different, and Ohio State's going to get the ball, Kirk, to begin the third quarter here, trying to solve some things on offense. Urban Meyer said terrible. That's how he described the offense.
That was his quote, and I think he's frustrated just because he's unable to see his offense be able to get down inside Oklahoma territory and come away with points. Just, again, they're not able to find a rhythm with a balanced attack, running and throwing. And so far, we've seen JT Barrett just 5 of 11 for 25 yards throwing the football.
Ball is going to be brought out. And this is a nice return here. Paris Campbell can fly, blazing speed. Kicker tries to cut him off and just does save a touchdown. Paris Campbell, electric speed.
Boy, he does a good job of setting up the blocks as if he's going up the middle, and then he just follows a couple blockers right there, and now he's out in the open field. And as you said, Chris, he's got a lot of speed when he gets out there. We saw that last week against Indiana when he just ran away from the Indiana defense, and Ohio State starts their first drive of the second half in Oklahoma territory.
It took a short pass, raced 74 yards to the end zone to break that open. 56 yards on this kickoff return.
You'll see Ohio State try to be much more aggressive with their play calling.
That woke up the horseshoe. There's a buzz finally here. And Barrett rolls as Chase delivers complete on the far side. McLaurin trying to escape and finally knocked down inside the 40.
You know, you saw Oklahoma with what I thought a much more aggressive approach with Lincoln Riley, taking that us against the world. We're going on the road, a tough environment. We're going to take some swings. And I think you're going to see Ohio State, if they're going to win this game, they're going to have a similar approach where instead of being, you know, a little bit more conservative, they've got to be more aggressive.
Dobbins, who was held in check in the first half, makes a little stutter step and a nice cut. He is a high-energy player. First down inside the 25.
They don't block DJ Ward. They actually read him right here. They're not going to touch him. 16's responsible for him. He stays wide. He takes the quarterback. He hands the ball off, and the others are blocking for big yards.
McLaurin in motion. This is Dobbins. You don't want to hype a kid after one game, but the skill set is reminiscent of a, you say it, a Reggie Bush?
Well, I think he, you got to remember, he's a true freshman, yep. But he's much more powerfully built as a true freshman than Reggie Bush, especially his lower body. But he's got a burst like that.
Barrett keeps it, and he's knocked down after a short gain.
Ohio State, they did the same thing last week against Indiana. Urban Meyer took Kevin Wilson, Ryan Day, the offensive staff in, and said, listen, we've got to make JT Barrett more a part of the running game because it sets up other aspects of our offense, like the play-action pass.
He is on the run, and catch is made on the edge by Benjamin Victor. First time he's gotten involved, and Ohio State, another first down.
Ohio State, early in the year, still trying to find that go-to guy. They feel they have six. But at some point, you get into games like this, who's he going to turn to make that play?
He wanted to throw to Dobbins out of the backfield. He was well covered. JT Biden his time, tucks it, and slides down at the six. Already he's run the ball 12 times tonight.
And again, there's the tempo. He's already ready to snap the ball again. And what they're doing right now, that's a rush three, drop eight, and a great answer by JT Barrett.
Caronquo down on the ground. He always, hey, these are modern times. You get a little suspicious when a defensive player goes to the ground. Try to slow the tempo.
But that Urban Meyer likes to go with.
Dobbins lined up behind Barrett on second and two. Freshman's got it. And he's got a touchdown. Finally, Ohio State finds the end zone. First possession of the second half.
It goes back to the kickoff return to give them great field position. Watch the block by Michael Jordan. Helps on the double team and then climbs to the freshman linebacker, Kenneth Murray. Chip gets up, and there's the size. And now J.K. Dobbins can kind of sneak behind those big linemen, most of which are 6'7".
Did everything last week in his debut, but score a touchdown. And now the first of what figures to be many touchdowns in the Buckeye career of J.K. Dobbins out of LaGrange, Texas. Right up the middle as the Buckeyes move it 44 yards after Paris Campbell's kickoff return up by a touchdown.
Welcome back to the Dr. Pepper Championship Drive Game of the Week.
Well, the Campbell kickoff return to begin the second half got this place jumping, and then Ohio State moving it 44 yards. First career touchdown for J.K. Dobbins. And now Baker Mayfield minus his tight end, Andrews, who's done for the game with a knee problem. This is the first 7-point deficit. Bottle moves it short, and Bidette will have a chance. Jeff Bidette trying to answer Campbell's heroics. Just held up briefly and finally tackled at the 34. Maria?
Well, hey, Chris, you know, I spoke to J.K. Dobbins' parents before this game, and they said that their son looks very comfortable on the field, and I think we saw it in that touchdown run. But check out the celebration, the silencer, an ode to LeBron. That's probably because Ohio State is wearing fresh new LeBron cleats, which they all have been practicing in. I did get an update, though, from Oklahoma's Lincoln Riley, and so far he's dealing with a lot of injuries. He said Baker Mayfield is definitely dealing with cramps. Mark Andrews, he said, we will see, but he's still not putting pressure on that left leg. And also Will Johnson, a starting safety for Oklahoma. He left without his helmet in the first half, returned without his helmet, and is sitting on the sidelines right now, guys.
All right, if you had to pick a few guys you don't want hampered, they would be in a short list. Future back tonight's been Trey Sermon. So they'll have to look for some other answers. You suggested that Dimitri Flowers will get involved. We saw C.D. Lamb, the true freshman, makes some catches early, but the receivers haven't been involved that much lately.
No, they've been using the backs and rotating the backs in and out. It wouldn't be surprised at all to see Lamb get more involved, but you're going to see Calcaterra get opportunities and also Dimitri Flowers, along with those running backs in that backfield, to continue to rotate guys in and out.
Slant, and the catch is made there for a short gain by Michael Jones, his first catch of the season. It's right near the marker. They'll move the sticks. First down.
Baker Mayfield trying to find matchups to his advantage. Soft coverage against Damon Webb. He had tight coverage on his outside receivers, so he takes the easy throw.
Buckeyes rush four down the middle. There's a catch by the freshman tight end. Grant Calcaterra filling in for Andrews, his first tonight.
They're going to go fast here, but Calcaterra is going to split the safeties and try to get behind the linebacker. You can't put too much air under it. You got to throw it on a line, which is exactly what he's able to do by splitting the safeties. A good route by the young freshman. That time he holds on to the ball. And again, Baker Mayfield, when he has time to throw from that pocket, he sets his feet. He's going to make an accurate throw.
13 for 20 for Baker so far. Picked up 21 yards there. Batted down at the line of scrimmage. That was big Draymond Jones again. He's been getting a good push against that offensive line.
And that's really all you can do. With the ball coming out as fast as it is, you get a push, then you go up into the air. Jones at 6'3", 295 pounds. He moves incredibly quickly and does a good job of getting up to bat the ball down. It's about the third time Baker Mayfield has had to deal with a big D lineman in the interior up in his face trying to bat the ball down.
Flowers and Sermon flanking the quarterback. And they fake it to him wide open over the middle. It's Flowers running free. Dimitri Flowers, touchdown, Oklahoma. And the Sooners answer quickly. ...36 yards for the versatile H-back.
And a changeup with two backs that you identified before the snap. We've been playing a lot of one back. This time they put Flowers back there with a true freshman, Sermon. And watch the linebackers come up thinking run, and it opens it up for Flowers to sneak behind him. They're coming up thinking the freshman's going to get the ball. Flowers sneaks in behind, and that gives you an idea what he can do after he makes the catch on Eric Smith.
Seibert ties the game. All right, Kirk, this is more like it here.
Here we go.
Making some plays.
Here we go. Got a ball game.
Look at,
there's that energy.
Harry Mayfield here. He loves the challenge of playing on the road in front of a hostile crowd, and he's got some adversity to deal with tonight. Answers the 7-point deficit with Flowers' second career touchdown. 10 apiece. Get him fired up.
Do not underestimate what that does for a team that's on the road that has a lot of youth in some key areas. This guy is he's like in basketball, a great point guard that you can go on the road and win with a great point guard. They feed off of his energy, and a big touchdown like that after they get down 10-3, offense hasn't put touchdown on the board. That's a huge play for Oklahoma to believe that they can win this game.
First guys he went to were the kickoff coverage team who gave up the big return to Campbell the last time. This time the kickoff is very deep. And look at the touchdown play.
Yeah, Chris, they've been able to run the ball. They've been running a little bit with Baker. They've been running with Trey Sermon. When you run with Sermon, look how it affects the defense, because they've got to come up and they get their eyes out of position. And once you get Flowers the ball, Chris and I have talked about him throughout this game, his versatility. He could be an H-back because of the injury to Andrews. He can play tight end. He can play fullback. They can line him up as a tailback. Brings a lot of versatility to what this offense tries to do.
Not afraid to throw a block either.
That's right.
Targeted four times, and there is the head coach, who's just 12 years older than his quarterback. And Mayfield told me that Riley hasn't changed at all since he's become the head coach. He's just the same guy, very grounded. He thinks very mature for 34, which is goes without saying. So Ken Barrett and the Buckeyes answer. And give it to Dobbins, the freshman, who makes a nice cut. Didn't look like a whole lot, but because he's so quick, he got 8 yards.
He gets to the corner in a hurry.
Hope you consider joining us for the men's championship at the U.S. Open tomorrow. Rafa Nadal goes for his third U.S. Open title and 16th major. Gets one of the great stories. Former Fighting Illini All-American, South African Kevin Anderson, big 6'8" player. 4 o'clock Eastern time. Dobbins, look out. Oh, just a shoestring tackle made by Neville Gallimore to prevent a huge play.
This is Robert Barnes, who's a true freshman. Watch this. Watch Barnes come up and think he's going to make a play. Fell to his knees. That's the R1 on the PlayStation on Madden right there. Ran him, almost took it to the house.
Dobbins could do that to a lot of guys in his career. Spinning and twisting for another big gain inside the 40. All of a sudden, this Buckeye offense comes to life.
76, the right guard comes down, gets the linebacker Emmanuel Beal. And we talked about, what is Ohio State going to do differently? Tempo and aggressive approach, and that's working for him right now.
We fake it to Dobbins, and now taking a downfield shot is Barrett from Mack, who makes a leaping catch down near the 5. Now they say incomplete. Did not control the ball to the ground. He's slow to get up. Robert Barnes was in coverage. Looked like he had it initially.
You got to complete the catch all the way through. Boy, look, sure, this will be interesting for Dave Kataya to take a peek at this. Dave, we talk at the seminar a lot on this exact example. And this would be great for you to walk through us and the fans, because
out
sometimes hands, and that's the second act that Dave was referring to.
No, he came down inbounds, though, so I don't, if he hadn't done anything, it still was going to be a catch. 31 yards sets up Ohio State first and goal. And Mike Weber is in the game. Option. Barrett turns it up. They were all over the tailback Weber, so a short gain there. Marquise Overton with the stop.
That is a great effort up front by Lampkin as well, just stringing that out.
Some tempers after the play. Oklahoma players pleading for a call. There is none. Weber is split out wide right. Now motions in. Barrett. Nowhere to run. They are focusing on the quarterback, Emmanuel Beal. Got him in a sandwich. It'll be third and goal.
Yeah, good job of attacking downhill by Emmanuel Beal. Talked about the experience he gained last year. I think you can see he plays much faster. He's trusting his eyes, and he's playing a lot quicker, especially down tight inside this top, inside the 10-yard line.
This wasn't easy in the opener for Ohio State to punch it in close either. Third down. Weber split wide left. JT from the pocket. Looks to the end zone. Over the head of Hill. Got a hand on it. But it's fourth down.
Oklahoma sat in zone coverage. JT Barrett has time to throw. He's just waiting for K.J. Hill to work to the corner. If he puts a little bit more air underneath that ball, K.J. Hill is able to run underneath it, just off the fingertips.
So after a 69-yard drive, Nurnberger on for his second chip shot of the evening. Made good from 24 earlier. And is now 2 for 2 from that distance. So, 3 scoring drives so far in the third quarter, Iowa State. So, Meyer's team once again with the lead. Injuries are mounting on both sides. Austin Mack, who made that terrific catch to set up the field goal, was carted off without his helmet. His head hit the ground hard as he did complete that catch. I think he posted. But Death in that corner from the 10. Not much room to run when they kick it and cover it that well. Check out our Pacific Life game summary, Kirk.
In a game that was 3-3 at halftime, finally the offenses woke up in the second half. Ohio State starts in plus territory. J.K. Dobbins puts Ohio State up 10-3, and Baker Mayfield, they get the ball right back, move it right down the field. Eventually, Dimitri Flowers on a play-action pass, touchdown to tie it up, and Ohio State gets the field goal in their last possession to go up 13-10. But seen a little bit, not a little bit, a lot more offense just in a half a quarter than we probably saw in the whole first half.
Meanwhile, we haven't seen Will Johnson, the starting DB for Oklahoma, return. Mark Andrews out. Mayfield is playing through some cramps here. Two back look with Anderson and Flowers. What a cool night to suffer cramps. It's only high 50s, but he put so much energy into the game. It's a short game by Anderson. And I think here comes a flag on the tackle. You know, I think, you know, we love the intensity and the nervous energy, but you tell me in tennis that can contribute to cramping. You burn a lot of fuel doing that. Getting keyed up.
Yeah. And these guys, especially.
Personal foul, chop block, number 72 and number 36. Half the distance of the goal, replay first down.
So Flowers and the left guard, Ben Powers, combining on the chop block.
And Ben Powers, left guard, is pulling around, and see him right here in the middle of the screen. Once he engages, you cannot go submarine as go down the guy that's being blocked, and that's what Flowers did. Illegal chop block, officials right there on top of it.
It looked like Powers knew the rule and tried to back off.
He tried, but once you make contact, it's over.
So first and 21 after the penalty. Mayfield knocked backwards and brought down at the one by Nick Bosa.
Hey, Chris, how about Eric Wren trying to make this block as a center? He's pulling outside to try to block this big guy right here. Watch this. He gets to the outside, gets overpowered with a left arm from Nick Bosa, just throws him into the backfield. And Baker Mayfield surprised that Bosa gets in that quickly.
Louder than it's been all night. Second and 30.
Loudest part of the stadium.
Play clock winding down. Mayfield steps up from the end zone and delivers a short pass out to the 10-yard line. Flowers gets some pressure yardage, but it'll be third and very long.
Takes some courage to go back up into that end zone. But the crowd comes alive. Baker Mayfield trusts his offensive line to give him just enough time, just to give him a little bit of breathing room instead of having to throw halfway into his end zone.
And a closed end of the old horseshoe, vibrating. Now they try to make it very tough on this veteran quarterback. They need 22. Play clock running down again as Mayfield rolls and delivers a short pass to Bidette on the sideline. He's knocked out short of the first down by Denzel Ward. More comfortable room to punt, though.
Yeah, that's just playing field position. You're not going to pick up the first down. Try to pick up 10, 12 yards. Try to push Ohio State back to have to start their next drive instead of punting from maybe inside your own 10-yard line.
And Seibert, who punted just once in the blowout of UTEP, punting for the first time tonight. A.J. Hill for the Buckeyes standing at his 35. Buckeyes come after it hard. It away a little methodically. It's a low kick. Hill comes up, no fair catch, picks it at the 40, and now decides to retreat and stays alive and will make a very exciting punt return for no gain. There's a lot going on there. They came after the punt hard, though, Ohio State. Got pretty close to Seibert.
I think he ran about 25 or 30 yards to get back to the, what was that, a plus one return?
Maybe. Our annual week one Monday Night Football doubleheader on ESPN kicks off Monday, 6:55. Saints and the Vikings, and at 10:15, the LA Chargers battle the Denver Broncos. So the NFL players can't come and any longer hang out and watch their alma mater. So a bunch of them around last week when you get to work. It was a 0-yard return after all the excitement.
After all that.
Just FYI. So the Buckeyes with the football and a 3-point lead. It used to be a steady diet of Dobbins and Barrett. Caronqua, another tackle. He has been a beast to block tonight.
This guy is just a big-time player, not just tonight, but all year. Watch him collapse on his play. He's not even supposed to be a factor on the play. But the play was a little bit slow in developing. Dobbins waiting to kind of find the hole. He better hurry up because 31's collapsing and holds him for actually no gain at all.
Dobbins keeps a cut, but he's getting dropped. It's DJ Ward. Is this defensive line for the Sooners understands the moment here. They've got to prevent Ohio State's offense from just building momentum here.
Well, it's beginning at that point where it starts to become critical. Each down, each possession, because not only obviously you're trying to put points on the board, but worst case, you're playing field position too. Leaving their corners on islands here.
Third and 10. Sooner lineman with some very wide splits trying to keep Barrett in the pocket. He rolls and escapes. Thought about throwing downfield and will scamper for the 45, but he's not going to get first down yardage. Barnes forced him out. There's a flag. Remember, you might suggest there'd be a hold.
Yeah, I think it's going to be on the right guard. Brandon Bowen grabbed a hold of an Oklahoma defender's jersey.
Let's see if Riley decides to decline the penalty. It's fourth down. He wants to know exactly how far Ohio State would need. He wouldn't figure Meyer would gamble from this position of three.
Holding. Offense, number 76. Penalties declined. Fourth down.
They were spotted, you know, fourth and five. And here comes the punt team. Good job by the Sooner defense.
Absolutely.
That time.
Three and out. Keep in mind, just a few plays ago, Oklahoma was snapping the ball offensively inside their own 5-yard line. They're able to get out of there and punt the ball away, and now a chance to get the football out after the three and out by the defense. But when they're coming after JT Barrett, they are putting a lot of pressure not only on Barrett, but on that offensive line.
It's a different look, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Now you see Barnes down being looked at as Chrisman again will try to pin Oklahoma deep. That just lets it bounce, and that's a beautiful job. Backspin. And pounced on right there. And once again, Oklahoma, for the umpteenth time tonight, will have very poor field position. Kickoff here, week one NFL Sunday with ESPN. New team and a new time. Sunday NFL countdown, now on at 10 o'clock Eastern time. Rex Ryan, Charles Woodson, Matt Hasselbeck, Randy Moss, Jeff D. Mort, and the new host, Samantha Ponder. She makes the move from the college side of the NFL.
We're Sammy.
Watching Sam.
Sammy, all the best.
10 o'clock Eastern start time on ESPN.
You know, Urban Meyer, when you sit down and talk to him, you want to talk offense, you want to talk defense. He probably takes as much pride in special teams and hidden yardage in the field position game as any coach out there. So, you know, in fact, Oklahoma is starting deep in their own territory, and they've averaged their starting position has been about their own 22-yard line. Kind of plays to his advantage. It's a stat that he pays very close attention to, where his offense starts on average versus where the opponent starts.
Chrisman is a freshman. He's got the look of guys who do this job for 4 years. Taking off is Anderson, and Rodney Anderson knocked down at the 13. A flag again. Almost a penalty-free first half, but they're beginning to pile up here. Mayfield says it's defensive holding. And Riley says we'll take that penalty. But Mike DeFee has the final
holding
word.
Holding defense, number 93. A 10-yard penalty will be added to the end of the run. First down.
It's absolutely untrue that the crew throws flags so you can get a look at Mike's arms. There's absolutely not true. But there have been more penalties after halftime here.
Time. Tracy Sprinkle in the middle of that Ohio State defensive line, trying to keep people off the linebackers, just grabbed two Oklahoma offensive linemen. Just tackled them.
Sprinkle, one of those tough guy veterans, a survivor, a fifth-year senior in this program. Mayfield, pressured immediately, slithers free and delivers the ball to the sidelines, and breaking free is C.D. Lamb, the freshman that got up to a fast start, but he's been quiet since.
I always refer to him as a young Brett Favre. The defense slants, angles this way, catches the offensive line off guard, catches Baker off guard, but look at the Houdini act. This is Baker Mayfield. That's what he does. But I got to give their young receiver, Lamb, a lot of credit, working with a veteran quarterback, sees that he's scrambling, works back to him to pick up the first down.
Just pinballing off his guard, Samia. 17 yards, and Mayfield scampering away again, fires downfield, has a man wide open. Michael Jones worked free. Mayfield on the run spots him, and the Sooners set up in the red zone.
Watch him get outside of six this time, Sam Hubbard, and then getting the ball out of his hands quickly allowed that ball to get over Kendall Sheffield. If he waited just a split second longer, till Sheffield sinking back into coverage, he would have been able to get up there and knock that ball down. But he saw his receiver, got rid of it quick, and that's why the ball was able to elude Sheffield dropping.
Mayfield now over 300 yards passing, a guy who broke an NCAA passing efficiency record a year ago. Very sharp tonight. He's been battling through some leg issues. They fake it to Anderson. A dart across the middle. Touchdown. Lee Morris has given Oklahoma the lead. What a drive for Mayfield. Lee Morris, a second-generation Oklahoma Sooner. His dad, Lee, was a wide receiver in the middle 80s. First time Oklahoma has had the lead, and it comes in a 92-yard, lightning-quick, four-play drive. Just a minute 40 to move also almost the entire field. Well, we didn't have many fireworks in the first half, Herbie. I'd say we're making up for it here.
Oh, no doubt about it. How about Oklahoma showing screen, kind of a delay look to the outside. They show screen left. Watch how he uses his head to get the defense out of position and then finds the receiver for the touchdown. Just a great job of Baker Mayfield looking left, showing the screen. And then the receiver, who's actually showing Morris, is showing that he's blocking, releases free, and is open.
Now we'll see if JT Barrett and the Ohio State offense can answer. That is a strong job by a road team.
Chris, it blocks, and it showing the screen, and then the release. What a competitor. Baker Mayfield.
I mean, we talked about what it takes as a leader and as a team to come in here on the road to the 34-year-old head coach's first real test as a head coach. And say OU's tradition has established under Stoops of being a team capable of standing up to all this on the road is still alive.
No doubt about it. As long as Baker Mayfield's under center and competing and this team's responding from his leadership, they always have a chance.
Seibert trying to take the Campbell return out of play, and he does so by just booting it through the end zone. Let's check back with Cassidy Hubbard in the studio. Cassidy?
The head coach for the Sooners, and now to have to be up there, just watching.
As his hand-picked successor, Lincoln Riley, faces this test, and his brother Mike Stoops now tries to get Oklahoma's defense to rise up and make a play. Buckeyes have had success after halftime running the ball, and now they throw it downfield, and it's a good play to break it up. I held off because Hill Houghton arrived just at the right time. No flag.
Houghton is a junior, has great athletic ability, and the closing speed there is was able to separate that ball thrown just a little bit behind Marcus Ball.
The timing on the passing game, all the components that they've worked so hard to get together, protection, routes, throws, still not clicking. What they're doing on second and 10. Now they'll go back to the run game. Barrett up the middle. And it's just a reliable play. It makes it third and short.
It's just a very comfortable play for Barrett. He reads that defensive end, body language. Time he stuck with J.K. Dobbins, made it easy for him to pull it, pick up those yards.
Needing four, Barrett stands in and delivers a strike, and the catch is made by Victor, who moves the chains out across the 45.
Just good spacing that time against the zone defense. Talked about, you know, seeing the protection, the routes, the quarterback play, all being on the same page. That time on third down, able to spread the Oklahoma defense out, and Victor just sat in that zone.
Been hearing about Victor's talents for a couple of years now. Expected to be an impact receiver for this team this year. Now Barrett sees an open end and just scampers down near the Oklahoma 42-yard line. Another first down.
And there's a mix-up there for Oklahoma. Okoronkwo actually turns his back and runs. Watch 31 run out of the picture with a tight end. The only problem is Jordan Thomas also ran with a tight end, leaving nobody to protect the left edge for the Oklahoma defense.
That's the kind of thing that would make Mike Stoops tear his hair out in the box. They lose contain. Final minute now of the third quarter. What an exciting third quarter. JT rolls and flips it downfield. Too high. Victor went up, but he was out of bounds. And again, the timing just not quite clicking. Victor was open for a time there.
He was open, but you also had Stephen Parker almost baiting him into throwing that ball. And I think that's what kept JT from turning it loose. And it's one thing the coaches want to see against Mike Stoops and the Sooners is a willingness from JT Barrett to just don't wait to be 100% sure. Just sometimes get back, trust it, and let it loose.
Dobbins fights for a short gain. And Barrett just 81 yards passing. Kirk, and 31 of those yards came on the catch by Matt. So 50 yards total in his other 8 completions. Mike emphatically making his point. Another third down play for that Sooner defense. Ohio State needs 7. Good protection. Catch was initially bobbled. Hill trying to work his way free. He's not going to get the first down. And if he'd made a clean catch, perhaps could have turned up. But as it was, Stephen Parker forced him out. Fourth down.
Yeah, clean catch and maybe turning back to the inside. He turns to the outside, and now he's got to outrun the defense. If he turned back to the inside, he probably would have picked up the first down.
So a fourth down decision for Urban Meyer to make as the fourth quarter begins. Back to Columbus after this message and a word from your local ABC station. To begin the final quarter from Oklahoma's 36. They're just on the fringe field goal range of Nurnberger.
Either give the option route to the inside receiver on either side or JT Barrett on the corner, or option to run or throw.
You wouldn't bet against the quarterback keeper if you're Oklahoma's defense. Barrett rolls. They come after him, and he'll throw downfield again, just off the hand of KJ Hill. Sooners gave chase. Kenneth Murray, the middle linebacker, came after Barrett, and Oklahoma makes a stand.
Well, that is a tough throw to make on the run. Murray here scraping, but look in the background at the receivers. I mean, that is a tough throw to make to try to squeeze in for JT Barrett. He actually gives Hill almost a chance to make this catch. Heck of a throw, heck of an effort, but really, really difficult execution on fourth down.
You talk about a true freshman playing middle linebacker at this level. Yeah. I guess his head was kind of spinning in the opener, kind of a learning experience, but he showed some explosiveness to get after the quarterback there, forced the throw, and Oklahoma is going to finally have some decent starting field position. Best of the night at the 36.
Big stop by the Sooners. Get the ball back to Baker Mayfield. Now up 4.
Again, Ohio State close when executing some downfield throws tonight, but not quite. feeds Sermon. Heavy traffic and no gain. Well, Mayfield's thinking, hey, let's get back to the passing game. I'm in a rhythm here. We've got guys open.
Well, he's 19 to 27 for 322 yards and a couple of scores. He and Lincoln Riley in sync, very comfortable with each other, being in this role in the last couple years, play caller and quarterback.
From the pocket, Mayfield flips it short. Sprinty crosses, but dead. Man, he has some quicks. He was a featured receiver at Kentucky last year, and they are glad to have him in Norman.
Well, incredible speed. Watch the freshman kind of lead the way. He comes out of the backfield. He's got to be careful of blocking too far downfield unless that ball's behind the line of scrimmage, but does a good job of creating a traffic jam. And give an idea what Bidette can do when he turns the corner, gets outside of Worley. Man, he can go.
1,300 receiving yards a year ago in the SEC. Mayfield still got it. Looking downfield. Loops it down there for Lamb, who is knocked down and draws several penalty flags. There are three on the field as the freshman had to be tackled, or that would have been a touchdown.
Now the freshman got behind both Ohio State defenders. To me, it looked like Damon Arnett trying to catch up.
Pass
ran right into him.
Defense, number three. 15-yard penalty from the previous spot. Automatic. First down.
Baker's frustrated with himself because he waited a little bit too long. The ball ended up being thrown late because he waited. He had him beaten, but watch three. Trying to play catch up. He just runs right into the freshman, but he was beaten badly. Got behind him.
Penalty moves it to the 37 as the Sooners now try to stretch the four-point lead early in the fourth. It's Bidette on the pop pass. Quick penetration by Bosa. Bidette able to escape and make a positive gain. Got about four. Just had to elude the defensive end of the backfield.
Lincoln Riley is getting so much attention tonight as being the head coach and his first real big game as a head coach. The thing I'm going to really appreciate tonight is the other hat that he wears as a play caller, designing formations and different looks, being multiple, giving this a very talented Ohio State defense a lot to think about even before the ball is snapped. This Oklahoma offense very, very well prepared to come into this environment tonight.
And working without their top pass catcher, Andrews, who's out injured. Sermon knocked down at the 30 by Jalen Holmes. It'll be third and short. What a way to respond, this Oklahoma team, Kirk, that the kick return by Campbell. Ohio State jumps in front, and since then, this Sooner offense has just clicked into a new gear.
You've got it because of the injury to Andrews. You've got a true freshman stepping in at tight end, Calcaterra. You got a transfer from Kentucky, Bidette playing. You got a true freshman at receiver in Lamb, true freshman running back in Sermon. That's all these guys that are surrounding Baker Mayfield that are playing a lot of ball tonight.
And they lost, you know, Ryan and Mixon and Westbrook. Some studs being replaced by some very young guys. There's a slant. There is, again, Lamb, the freshman, and another first down at the 22. Boy, is he really a true freshman?
Yeah. And they told us, it's a strong comment. But and you talk to these coaches behind closed doors, a lot of them are very honest with you. They said that Lamb has a chance to be one of the better receivers that they've recruited in a long, long time. They've had some special recruits and athletes go through there as a receiver. Sterling Shepard, Mark Clayton going way back. You think about some of the guys that they've had.
Nobody until him, though, had started their debut as a true freshman at that position ever at Oklahoma. Again, there's that tricky direct snap, and Sermon's got it off and running. Bangs down, still going in the 10-yard line, and Ohio State's been caught off guard by that repeatedly as the snap doesn't go to Mayfield, but a back.
Absolutely. Samia coming around the right guard. Flowers, hat on a hat. Next thing, he gets to the second level, and there's nobody there. He gives a stiff arm to the safety, Damon Webb. So kind of a slow, methodical counterplay. But they get a hat on a hat with the backside pulling around. And Sermon, who's got power at 225 pounds, running through that second and third level of the defense.
you know, and it develops faster, Kirk, because you don't have to hand the ball off to him. Just snap it and go.
He does have to pause just enough to let that guard and backside H-back come around.
Mayfield, look left, has room, now throws it. Touchdown, Sherman muscles in the end zone, and the Sooners stretch the lead to double digits.
I love you.
Left tackle there to congratulate the true freshman. Some guys are growing up in a hurry on the road tonight.
That's a great catch by Sermon, but are you kidding me with Baker Mayfield? Are you kidding me?
12 of his last 13.
With that throw, the way he steps up, you think he's going to maybe take off? Somehow he squeezes that throw into a true freshman for a touchdown?
You may have all those freshmen on the field. You got a veteran quarterback leading this offense in Oklahoma, making a strong statement, up 11 now on the road.
This is incredible. This gives you an idea. Watch it. He's looking right. You're going to think, oh, he's going to take off. He's going to scramble. He's going to take off. Nope. He finds the freshman. How about the freshman? The catch, lowers his shoulder, able to get right through to Damon Arnett.
Here's the progressive pylon cam. Mayfield is in the zone after limping around here much of the first half. The Sooners have roared back. 11-point lead. Mayfield just on fire in the second half. Seibert once again boots it too deep for Campbell to make an impact. Here's our Pacific Life game summary, Kirk.
Boy, what a different half from what we saw in the first half, and it was 3-3. You can see the points that was scored in the third. We're just getting into the fourth quarter already. Oklahoma with a touchdown, 21 points for the Sooners alone in the second half. And Baker Mayfield, look at that, 354 yards through the air.
You're Ohio State, you've got time, Kirk, but you also got an offense that was one of the worst in the country, frankly, at creating big downfield pass plays a year ago. Worked hard on it, but they haven't really materialized in the first games so far this year. 11-11 to work with. The lead is 11. Barrett again throws low, picked off. Going down low is Parnell Motley. First takeaway for Oklahoma, and they are set up.
I think the pressure affected JT Barrett to have to really telegraph where he's going to go with the ball. You'll see eventually Murray's able to get through there, but Motley baits him. He's already sitting back here. He knows because of the scramble, he's going to have to get the ball out of his hands. He baits JT Barrett, who telegraphs the throw, and he steps right in front of it to give the Sooners outstanding field position.
Barris, first pick of the season. And again, it's Kenneth Murray, that freshman linebacker, just exploding toward the quarterback to force a throw.
Just by him getting in and JT Barrett having to move to his right, that allows the secondary to know, okay, the ball is coming out. Motley just sat behind him, waited for it to be thrown, and then made the interception. I guess they're taking a peek to
double
see if
check,
he got it.
Make sure the ball didn't hit the ground here. Two reversals have gone Ohio State's way. Let's check out this one.
Thought he got his elbows underneath that.
Good from that angle. Never. Not definitive. This one will be. He's rolling over on his hip.
Yeah, but the ball never touched the ground.
Trying to protect the ball.
The ball could have come out, but it never touched the ground.
Yeah, that's going to stand.
Yep.
So Parnell Motley, excuse me, stepping in here.
Mike Stoops telling us this week that for the first time in a few years, he feels better at the cornerback spot despite the injury to Jordan Parker. He still has Motley and Jordan Thomas.
The ruling on the field is confirmed. Interception, first down.
And when you have guys like Jordan Thomas and Parnell Motley, and you got a couple true freshmen in Trey Norwood and Trey Brown, it affects the rest of the defense. Last couple years, because of injuries and youth, they've been handcuffed somewhat on what they could do in coverage and with their secondary. I think Mike feels very, very differently about the group that he has in the back end. in 2017.
If you think about Jordan Parker, he's out with a knee injury. They lost Will Johnson, one of their senior leaders in the secondary. He left with what appeared to be concussion protocol on the first half. So now Mayfield trying to add to an 11-point lead. Flips it short to Sermon again. And the freshman staying busy tonight, picks up five.
Good, a true freshman is Sermon. And literally, you could feel him aging on every snap. Got in early for the spring, went through winter conditioning and spring football. First feel of big time football, 10 carries, 41 yards, the big catch there earlier to give him that touchdown to go up 24-13. But just playing with moxie and maturity here tonight.
It's good penetration. Buckeyes storm through. And that's Robert Landers dropping Anderson for a loss. Eric conferring upstairs. The brain trust, hoping his defense can get him the ball back.
This is, for Ohio State's defense, a big play. If they want to try to stay within just a couple possessions and try to force OU into a field goal. Down 11, under 10 minutes to go in this game.
Third and eight. And Mayfield looping one for the end zone. Coming back is Padet. No catch. Out of bounds. Denzel Ward defended him, and it's fourth down.
Ohio State tipped their hand. They just showed him right at the beginning. We are in man-to-man coverage. Good against good. Very, very close to that left knee getting down for a reception. Denzel Ward, their best cover guy. Against Padet, that left knee comes down just out of bounds.
Let's take another look, but I agree with you. It looked like the knee hit the paint.
But how about Ohio State saying, okay, we're going to play man. Baker Mayfield look over to Lincoln Riley like, we're going to go with this? It's just, who can make a play?
It was kind of sandlot. Well, he was trying to direct the receivers.
You know, the foot get down the left first? Foot may have touched before the knee did.
Let's go to Dave Kataya. The focus was on the knee, but if the foot gets down, it's a catch. Dave, what did you see here in that replay?
I've got the toe tip down before that knee. Now watch. Here's the possession of the ball. There's the ball down. Now the knee.
Yep.
Does he have possession before the knee hits? The toe did hit first. Here's the progressive pylon cam.
No question there. The toe is down, but we can't see the ball from that angle. He has to control the ball going across the sideline.
There's another real close play.
I agree with Dave. I think he has possession.
Catch now.
Bear, foot down.
Yep. He's got it in his hands. It could not be closer than that. The knee just inches above that out of bounds when the toe hits.
By the way, another thing we don't want to look past. If this ends up being reversed, how about the throw from Baker Mayfield?
After further review, the receiver gained possession of the ball, got his left foot down. It's first and goal at the 3-yard line.
Now the folks in the upper deck and the Crimson are cheering, and Oklahoma is set up a chance to make this a 3-possession game.
How about Baker Mayfield? Again, the throw back shoulder away from Denzel Ward to give him his receiver a chance. Big third down. Great relationship, great chemistry. Kentucky Wildcat transfer. Had 28 starts when he played at Kentucky. This guy's played a lot of football in the SEC.
Had the fumble earlier, but has redeemed himself with a big night since. Mayfield has completed his last 12. Set up first and goal. Round end around and barreling in for a touchdown is Jordan Smallwood. His first career touchdown, and Oklahoma is blown it open. Four touchdowns after halftime by this Oklahoma offense.
One step ahead of Ohio State with the formations and the play calls, breaking tendencies, doing things that Ohio State's not expecting. This Oklahoma team, I said it earlier, I say it again, just incredibly well prepared to come in here to win this game.
And Smallwood, Kirk, the guy who has bided his time. He's a senior, has 11 career receptions, had never scored a touchdown until this one right here. Boom, that is a physical guy to try to bring down. And Ohio State respond. The deficit is 18.
Saturday Night Football on ABC is presented by Wells Fargo. Wells Fargo, building better every day. In part by Ford, going further so you can. And Pacific Life, experience the power of Pacific.
Four different Sooners have scored touchdowns in the second half. 21 unanswered points after Ohio State took a 13-10 lead. And some in the horseshoe have decided to head for the exits.
Something about Baker Mayfield and the OU Sooners, when they get on the road and wear those all-white unis, they play with a massive chip on their shoulder.
Mayfield, I mean, there's a lot of guys on this team with some dog in them. And meant that as a high compliment. Seibert with a high boot. And Campbell again will take a knee. This week on ESPN Sunday Night Baseball, AL Central Division leading Cleveland Indians hosting the Orioles. Coverage begins at 7 with Baseball Tonight's Sunday Night Countdown. O's and the Indians at 8 o'clock. The Indians are on a tear.
17 in a row. Always seem to peak the right time.
They're the best baseball team in Ohio this year by a lot, because your club is...
Well, my ball club shut her down a while back.
Did you switch over to become an Indians fan?
No. I'm one of those guys. I'm a diehard Cincinnati Redlegs fan the rest of my life. Got to stick with your team.
Let's see if these fans will stick with Ohio State. There's some urgency here. This possession down 18 to say the least. As Barrett from the pocket delivers across the middle, and Hill makes a tough catch in traffic, picks up 9.
Yeah, what makes it tough is this offensive line struggled all night in pass protection, and now it's obvious. I mean, the Oklahoma front, they're going to just come after them. They're going to do everything they can to disrupt the timing with JT.
That means keep an eye out for Obo Okoronkwo, who's been active tonight invading that backfield, number 31.
You know, one thing Urban Meyer wants to see is the ability to stretch the field. Has not been able to do that at all tonight.
False start. Offense. Number 73. 5-yard penalty. Second down.
I think that's the element in this offense. Kevin Wilson's come in. Ryan Day's come in. You got Urban Meyer. All these guys are incredibly bright, great, innovative offensive minds. And yet, if you don't have the personnel to stretch a field, stretch the defense, makes it very, very easy for a defense to not feel that threat and tighten everything up on the short and intermediate passing.
After the penalty at 2nd and 6, and McLaurin makes a catch. This is an offense that really, really misses Curtis Samuel, who surprised Meyer a little bit, he told me, by coming out. Noah Brown came out a year early, is sticking with the Cowboys, but Samuel was such a, he was the go-to guy when things were tough.
Yeah, but he was also, I mean, he's a great player, but he was so electrifying in space. And was more really more of a running back who learned how to play receiver. Devin Smith and Michael Thomas were the guys a few years ago that could get vertical and really threaten the defense. They haven't had that since those two players.
Barrett again has time that nobody will throw to and has to throw to the bench.
Again, you have three receivers there all at about 10 to 14 yards, and you've got four white jerseys with three scarlet jerseys. It's just nowhere to go with the football.
Imperative to score and also score quickly. You need three scores to reclaim the lead. Pretty much need a touchdown each possession if you're Ohio State at this point. Then you got to try to find out a way to stop Mayfield on the other end. Barrett again stepping up, looks for somebody, flips it over the middle. And that's Marcus Baugh, first down yardage at the 45 of Oklahoma.
And even on that play where Ohio State did try to send somebody downfield, Oklahoma took it away. Paris Campbell down the middle of the field. Sooners took it away, forced JT Barrett. They're taking all the deep stuff away when it shows up, making him throw underneath on the shorter throws. Keep the clock running if you're Oklahoma.
Finally over 100 passing yards tonight. And over the middle. And the catch by Johnny Dixon, another first down inside the 35. Dixon junior who's had an injury-plagued career, decided to come back to Ohio State for one more go after being talked out of quitting because of all that knee pain. There he is, South Florida, which is so threatened. Barrett from the pocket loops it downfield, looking for Victor, jump ball, and is one of those Floridians defended by Parnell Motley.
Time, even though he was covered for Ohio State during that timeout. You may have had Ryan Day, who's been working very hard with JT Barrett, bringing that NFL mentality. Day spent so much time in the NFL with Chip Kelly, saying, hey, even when they're covered, you can still throw it. Throw it, throw it, give your receiver a chance. He tried there with Victor to no avail.
Barrett zips it here. McLaurin makes the catch. He's not naturally a gunslinger, is he? Very different personality from Mayfield, so they want him to be a little bolder, right? Trust the receivers.
Yeah, and I think, you know, for him, I think he's still trying to find chemistry with these guys and really find out which each of their strengths are in these kind of games. I think that's where they were trying to get in a position last year with JT Barrett and these receivers.
They give it to Weber on third and one, and he makes a quick burst for a first down to the 16.
Yeah, Barrett's strength is his leadership, his ability to make plays with his feet, can create, find receivers. But at some point, as they go through this season, they're going to have to, like I said, get better at throwing the ball down the field.
And Barrett from the pocket flips it short. This is Weber. He's knocked out of bounds. Barrett came in tonight needing just two touchdowns responsible for to tie Drew Brees' Big Ten career record. He's going to clearly get it at some point. Not yet tonight, though. Inside of 7 minutes. Barrett for the end zone, throw it up, intercepted, and Parnell Motley has made his second pick tonight. And now they're going to rule incomplete. I thought he had it. He thought he had it. And they're coming in saying, nope, they hit the turf. The first one was a close call.
Yeah, I thought he had it too. I guess McLaurin trying to fight the ball out of there. I mean, he definitely initially makes the catch. Looks like he has it. Watch McLaurin try to pull at that football.
Well, he pulled it out really late.
Yeah, it looks like he was down.
And they're going to buzz this down. Ohio State's trying to run a play quickly before they can reverse it, and they don't get the replay in. So given a break, Barrett just throws it away. Boy, I have no idea why you wouldn't stop play. There's a flag on this play. Why you wouldn't stop play to check that out? Looked like Motley did have the interception. Be a holding penalty on Ohio State.
Well, he went up and made a play on the ball, took two steps with the ball in his hands before he went down, and then had the ball come out.
Holding, offense, number 59. Penalties declined, fourth down.
I mean, that's a pick that would have, this would have sealed the game. Another look.
Dave Kataya, walk us through there. Interception, one step.
You got a foot down.
Two steps.
He's still going.
Still has the ball.
Now, still has the ball.
Down.
The defender, to me, pulls the ball loose.
Yeah, but late, right?
Oh, absolutely.
Wow. Okay, so they don't buzz down.
That looks like an interception.
And reverse it. And now Ohio State's going to send out the field goal team. Okay. Had to cut it to 15. Theoretically, it's a two-possession game if you can cut the lead with 6:33 to play. Now, we will take a break. Buckeyes lucky to have any hope alive at this point. And Nuremberg does his job. It's 31-16. 6.5 to play. For some programs, over time, have a way of showing up on the road and pulling off upsets and just handling hostile environments. Oklahoma's that program, but Baker Mayfield is that quarterback. And you pointed out the role he's played beyond just making throws and running tonight of leadership.
Yeah, and remember, we saw him limping off the field a couple times early with possibly cramps. We don't know what the injury was, but he was going to fight through it. And his leadership, the intangibles that he brings to the table, he could see him in warmups. He was warming up with a chip on his shoulder. He's been talking to his team, the kickoff coverage team, the defense, the coaches, the trainers, everybody rallies around number six. And we talked earlier about how many new faces are around him, freshmen, transfers. It's incredible to see what he's been able to do tonight to get this team to believe. And the other thing is this defense feels different, yeah, too, for Mike Stoops. Totally different group than what they've had the last couple years.
I'm glad you said that, because a defense that was reeling early last year, they were gashed by Houston, by Ohio State, gave up a ton of points to TCU, won a shootout. But Stoops told you guys he feels much, much better about this group, and they are showing why.
It's gonna, a lot of people are going to talk about Lincoln Riley. You're going to see what Mike Stoops did tonight as well.
Onside kick, bounces free. That's very well executed. They just couldn't get to it before it went out of bounds. But Harbo gave his guys a chance. There is a flag for the ball going out of bounds. So Oklahoma will get the football back. It's a 15-point lead, a two-score game with 6.5 to play.
And we talked earlier about a report card for Baker Mayfield. What does he have to do? Here's three things we talked about. Ball placement, which he's done a very good job tonight. Getting the ball out of his hands quickly, under 2.7 seconds he's been able to do, and we've seen a lot of this. The creativity, really his signature play of the night, and what we've seen so many times over the years from Baker Mayfield. And there's the intangibles, if you wanted to add a fourth element to what he can do.
You said a couple of times, young Brett Favre, of course, played his college ball in Southern Mississippi. When you talk about one of the great quarterbacks in NFL history, that's big praise. You're talking about
talking about how he plays the game, the passion, the love. Young Brett Favre at Southern Miss, early at the Green Bay Packers. I'm not trying to say he's going to be the next Brett Favre as a quarterback in the NFL. I'm just saying the way he plays the game, some of the things that he does, the leadership that he provides, the way his team rallies behind him.
From the 49, this is Sermon, one of those freshmen for Oklahoma that has showed up big tonight on the road in a tough environment. Rips off nine more.
You know, not only Oklahoma wins this game, but you're talking about having guys that now are starting to become, even in the second game of the year, because of a willingness to play this game. You get ready for your next game, and the next game you get into conference play. These young players, they're not, this atmosphere will prepare them for everything that they're going to see the rest of the year. They're becoming more seasoned just by playing in this game tonight. Guys like Lamb, and talked earlier about Sermon and what he's done, Calcaterra.
Mayfield under center on second and short, just bulldozes for a first down. Baker told me, by the way, Kirk, that he worked hard this summer on his golf game, trying to improve the golf game. He's a lefty in golf, by the way. I don't know why. He's a right-handed thrower, but plays golf left-handed. Hits it far, working on the short game, but he says he may not have a future. Does he have the temperament for golf, the patience?
Oh, yeah.
I'm sure.
I bet he has a good time out there.
Oh, I'm sure he has a good time.
I bet he has a real good time.
He's a heck of a baseball player, a lefty hitter in baseball, too.
That's why he's golfing. His dad probably taught him at a young age. Extra step and a half, two steps to first base.
Bring it off again. Wrestled down behind the line by Sam Hubbard. And the reminder, pop back to New York City. Love the wheels up. At Allen Henderson at 4 o'clock Eastern time. The men's championship at the U.S. Open.
Give me a quick assessment breakdown, and then I'll be watching.
Anderson's big serves against Nadal's return. Rafa will try to make it physical, extend the rallies. We know what he can do in a final. Will Anderson hold his nerves in his first ever Grand Slam final? Biggest match of his life. Nadal's been there lots of times, but it's an interesting matchup.
Is anybody in tennis even close to Nadal as far as the conditioning? Because I know, honestly, you always talk about that aspect of his game being unique. Is there anybody even close?
I think guys work hard. I think it's a much more physical sport. I didn't think we'd be sitting here talking tennis, by the way, but I appreciate the interest. No, I mean, I think what's interesting about tennis, football is the ultimate team sport. You've got Mayfield and all these guys together encouraging each other. Tennis is lonely. You're out there by yourself in the world's biggest court.
You got your team.
Yeah, but they can't do anything for you. They can clap for you. I'm just saying it's a lonely environment. This is the ultimate team sport.
Yeah.
I love both sports for different reasons. But
well, you do a great job with both.
Hope you'll watch tomorrow. Thank you, Bert.
I will.
Sure.
I will, Bert. I'm all over the U.S. Open. I love it.
No, I appreciate it.
I'm in for the Grand Slams. You go over to Montreal and some of the others, I might veer off. But
I know you're up in the middle of the night from watching from Australia. I appreciate that. Man, Mayfield, 19-20 against UTEP. It was a beatdown. He played just a half. But you come in here and you do this kind of performance with all the intangibles, 25-33, 381, and three touchdowns against the defense that made life miserable for most passers last year. And I know it's early. I don't want to throw out the H word, but Baker Mayfield has twice been in the top four and been a finalist last year. I mean, he just continues to string amazing performances together.
How many times has that ever happened? A guy three times finishing up in the top four. Has that ever happened?
Tebow was around.
Did he do it?
Leonard as a sophomore and then came back twice more. But
you don't see that happen.
No.
He's off to a pretty good start at making that a reality.
Long way to go, but this was a huge hurdle to clear. Field slips it off to Flowers out of the backfield, and Dimitri spun down inside the 35 by Damon Webb. Mayfield's mother Gina making the trip up here. This is it's quite a memory. You watch your son come into this environment. You know what he went through, Kirk, by losing at home to Ohio State. You know what that loss meant to him, and to come back almost 12 months later and have this result.
Yeah, I thought it was interesting to see him come out publicly and say, not, hey, we put that one behind us. We won 10 in a row after that loss. We're not even thinking about that. No, he said, no. That stung. Not only to lose the game, but to have them sing their song on our field. That was something that we'll never forget. And he said that this week. And I think that will kind of give you an idea of what was inside his mind.
It started in the pregame.
Oh, yeah. He came in. And this is what he does, though. It's not just this game. This is how he plays. When you show up to a stadium and you see six doing this, put on your hard hat.
And by the way, he'd do this if there were no TV cameras and no crowd. If this was on an empty sand lot, his guys against the other guys, he'd be doing the same thing. And that's what's cool about it. Since that loss, now 39 touchdown passes and six interceptions. And now, Oklahoma will begin to join the conversation of those teams that are very serious playoff contenders, and the Big 12 is going to get a much-needed big respect road win against a second-ranked opponent, something this conference has had a hard time creating in recent years. This will shut up some of the skeptics. So fourth down and three play. They come after him, hand off inside, and they're going to pick up the first down with Sermon barreling inside the 30. Bleed off some more clock.
Start thinking about that Big 12 and some of the teams in there and some of the road trips that they have. I know they're on the road in Manhattan in October.
It was 55-0 last time they played there on the road, though.
Yep. And then they have to go Bedlam on the road in Stillwater.
It's different, of course. Bedlam, not the season ender. There's three games after the Bedlam rivalry. And, of course, mindful of that Big 12 championship game for the first time. TCU looks like a
TCU's
serious
a good,
test late
in the year. At home. West Virginia at home.
But suffice to say, they should be picking up some victories in the coming weeks.
Yep.
Without being tested too severely.
You know what it's going to be about now? Handling this. We talk a lot about Baker Mayfield. You got a new head coach. You got a lot of freshmen. And all of a sudden, after a win like this, you know how the media, everybody reacts. They're just going to put them ahead. Okay, Oklahoma. And how do they respond to that? Can they block all of the compliments out? Keep this edge. if you don't show up and play like this, this edge that they've had tonight, that toughness, you know, you can lose to anybody. So that'll be Lincoln Riley's big challenge, is trying to get his team to show up upset and angry when they play in these games. Because they're a handful when they do, as we saw.
Four wrap-up shows coming up after the game, Cassidy Hubbard. But if you think about it, the head coach who just turned 34 this week, how rare that is at his age to take over a program like this. Way back when, Paul Bryant was a head coach at 32. Most don't remember that he began his career at Maryland. Bob Knight, West Point basketball coach at 24. I think of Brad Stevens, who's a very young guy at Butler, and the Celtics head coach at 36. But there's not many 34-year-olds, actually 33 when he gets the job, come in here with this kind of command and handle this situation, and have that kind of respect from his team.
Has an old soul, though, when you talk to him. I mean, just one of those guys that, you know, hasn't been a head coach, but when you talk to him, because of the poise and the way he carries himself, kind of feels that he's been a head coach before.
The new All-State all-hands-in bus, helping us find great teamwork, great work in the community all season long. Rick, you got your All-State all-hands-in team of the week.
Yeah, each weekend during the Saturday Night Football coverage, I'll be sharing my All-State all-hands-in pick of the week, kind of the team that came together, the strongest on the field. And how can you not pick Oklahoma? Number 5 on the road at number 2. Up right now, 31-16. We talked all night about Baker Mayfield, 4 touchdowns and 5 possessions in the second half. And what's not there is Mike Stoops and the Oklahoma defense holding Ohio State to 16 points and shutting down JT Barrett.
Oklahoma faithful, who are tucked away in the upper corners of the horseshoe where the visiting folks usually sit, they have not left. This is going to be a satisfying memory, because not everybody around the country believed they would come in here and win, much less dominate Ohio State. Sermon again as a flag is down, breaks free into the secondary, barreling down near the 5. But we'll check the penalty flag right at the line of scrimmage.
I think Oklahoma had too many men in the backfield.
Illegal formation. 5 men in the backfield on the offense. 5-yard penalty from the previous spot.
Something to keep in mind. It's week 2. But last year, because of the willingness to play a home and home, Ohio State ended up going down and losing to Penn State after beating Oklahoma. And when the dust settled at the end, the committee rewarded Ohio State for going on the road and winning in Norman in the fashion in which they did. Now you fast forward to 2017. Who knows what's going to happen the rest of the year with the playoff and the committee and how it'll shape up. But Oklahoma coming to Columbus, and right now if they hold on 31-16, that is a major, major reward and something to remember as they get ready for the rest of their season and the rest of their resume, depending on what happens.
So you're saying that much like last week's Alabama win over Florida City, it gives you a cushion. You've gone on the road. You have a huge win. If you stumble once in the Big 12, the Big 12 is a conference that sometimes had a hard time believing to get a fair shake from the committee.
I'm saying that this boosts your discussion. This, anytime you get into an either or, and you're sitting there at 3, 4, 5, in late November, early December, people are going to point to this performance, 31-16 in Columbus, just like they pointed to Ohio State last year going to Norman and beating the Sooners.
4th and 8. Well, a home field loss has not knocked teams out. In fact, that's been a pattern to win a national championship. Lose a game at home.
Ohio State did that in 14 when they lost to Virginia Tech early.
Bama did it again. Losing at home and then coming back and winning
lost
the championship.
To Ole Miss. Yeah.
So that's the final play, as they don't make the first down, and Ohio State will take over. And a reminder that Monday Night Football doubleheader on ESPN kicks off at 6:55, Saints and the Vikings. And the Broncos battle the Chargers at 10:15. Eastern time. All right, we talked about the impact on Oklahoma. What about the Buckeyes here who did not accomplish tonight anything close to what the offseason emphasis was? Develop a more dynamic downfield passing game, stretch the defense. You know Barrett can run the ball. You know we've got a couple of good backs. Beyond that, what can they count on?
What they're going to count on is facing defenses that don't respect their vertical pass game. And until they prove it, what they're going to deal with is people crowding the line of scrimmage, crowding their short intermediate passing, and trying to get JT Barrett uncomfortable, make him sit in that pocket, hesitating. And they're going to have to come up with a plan and find some personnel that can help them stretch the field horizontally and vertically, because it makes it very, very tough if you can't do that.
Basically, Hand, out of the four halves played so far, one good half of football. It was the second half against Indiana.
That's a hold.
Yeah, flags are down. And the catch is made out near midfield, but Okoronkwo was just dragged to the ground. This will come back. He's been a handful.
Holding. Offense.
Which was,
no pun intended.
Which was
10-yard penalty from
big
the
scouting
spot.
Report, 31 in white against Ohio State's tackles. Unless they're going to chip or slide the protection one way, he could have a field day. And he's been in that backfield all night when they've turned him loose. So you're saying that we get some NFL action?
Yeah. But another reminder that the Sunday NFL countdown is on at 10 a.m. Eastern time. What a great cast. You got Rex Ryan jumping in there, Charles Woodson, Matt Hasselbeck, Randy Moss, Shefty Morton, Sam Ponder makes her debut. We'll be watching. From the pocket, JT fires across the middle. It's Campbell makes the catch, spins free. Knocked down, though, at the 34 inside of a minute to play. Mayfield will end this game with 14 straight completions after hitting his first 16 a week ago. In the flat, and the catch is made by Weber, who just runs out of bounds. Well, this will end with an almost empty house in the horseshoe. And some questions, you know better than anybody how tough this town can be, how loud the questions will be for Urban Meyer about this Ohio State offense. Barrett hit and hammered and knocked down. Mark Jackson, who's Okoronkwo's backup as the Jack linebacker, gets involved. And Lincoln Riley, 34 years old, is going to come to the horseshoe and beat Ohio State. 40 years ago, the Oklahoma comeback was known as the kick. This is the kick butt. 15-point margin. And Riley and the Sooners win their 12th straight, continue their road mastery. Final play of the game, Hill just steps out of bounds, and that's it. Oklahoma with 28 points after halftime. They have 21 unanswered after Ohio State had taken a 13-10 lead. Come to Columbus and dominate the number two team. In the Lincoln Riley era, with Bob Stoops looking on from the press box in delight, is off to a great start in Norman.
Wow, that is impressive for the Sooners. Impressive start to their season after the UTEP game, and now to come to Columbus and beat Ohio State and Lincoln Riley. Man, oh man, what a start to a, I'm sure, very brilliant future.
Well, let's hear from him after his second game. Maria Taylor with Lincoln.
Thanks, Chris. Well, I can see you guys are enjoying an embrace. What did you say to your quarterback after this match?
I didn't say anything to him. He was ready to play this game. He's the best quarterback in America, and he played like it tonight and led our team.
This team had to battle back in the second half. What allowed you to score 21 unanswered points out of the locker room?
We just fought. We knew offensively that we were really close. We played well the whole first half. And our guys just kept a lot of belief. Our defense, the way they played, keeping us in it, was great. And, you know, we're just a bunch of pretenders that are trying to win some games.
Pretenders, you're a head coach on the road for the first time. You're also a play caller. How did it feel getting the win in this one?
It's great. This is a great environment here. to win here. It doesn't happen very often. It's very, very special.
All right, I got to talk to your quarterback now since he's the best in the country, according to Lincoln Riley. What worked for you in the second half coming out of the locker room, Baker?
I think we just stayed to our game plan, you know, stuck to it. You know, we moved the ball well in the first half. We just kind of shot ourselves in the foot once we got across that 50-yard line. I thought we just stayed with it, and, you know, the good plays will come.
The good plays came a lot. What do you feel like was kind of the difference in the connections that you were able to make downfield in the second half?
I got great receivers, and they're making plays for me. They make it easy. I've had trust in them since the beginning of throwing to them, so, you know, I'm just giving them a chance, and they're making me look good.
All right, now, you didn't want to hear Ohio State sing O-H-I-O on your field.
I bet I'm about to go down there.
I was going
to
say, what are you about to sing now?
I'm about to sing Boomer Sooner. I mean, I don't know. I'll do everything down there. Maybe some JT.
All right, go get after it.
Yeah, they had to file off right behind Ohio State, which was doing their tradition, swaying and singing the alma mater. And now Oklahoma's having a party down there in the closed end of the horseshoe. And this is a well-earned party. What did he do right? What didn't he do right? 16 of 17 after halftime, 228 and 3 touchdowns. Ohio State's not giving up 800 passing yards in his first 2 games. So Mayfield picked apart a secondary that's got some work to do.
Think about this. It was 3-3 at halftime. Oklahoma had moved the ball and felt like they were in control, but they just weren't able to finish and put points on the board. And then in the second half, they scored 28.
He's still got enough energy to direct the band here. So give me the flag.
Somebody help my man unwrap the flag.
It took him a while to unwrap things in the offense tonight, but what a second half. Now, they don't play every year. The home-and-home series is over. So Ohio State, unless they play another 30 years from now, won't have this to worry about. But this is pretty sweet. He's going to do a victory lap. Some of you might not love this, but this is authentic. And this is because of what he felt and his teammates felt with a home field loss a year ago. This is the 45. This is the 50. Oh, no, he's not. No, he's not going to plant it in the midfield of the O, is he? Wow. Yes, he is. Ooh. Looks like the Ohio State band has come out of their seats. They didn't like that. There's no one here to defend the O except the band.
Wow.
But if the Buckeyes in the locker room saw that, they might come out and take issue. Now they're going to dance on the block, though.
That was surprising.
Well, if they felt disrespected, this was their statement. Wow. That'll be talked about a little bit, as will the result in the second half performance by Mayfield and the Sooners, who come into Columbus and smack down the second-ranked team in the country. 31-16 is the final with a furious second half by the Sooners. Tonight's game, produced by Bill Bunnell, directed by Jeff Evers. We thank our crew here in the booth. The Ford wrap-up show is coming up next year. Mayfield taking selfies. It's a night to savor for the Sooners, a 15-point road victory as they extend the nation's longest winning streak.
Get the money, man. I'm telling you.
Time for Cassidy Hubbard in the studio with that Ford wrap-up show.